I think you're gonna like this picture.
Love That Bob. Starring Bob Cummings.
Here. Teach him to play bridge.
Ladies and gentlemen, and Jimmy Randy fans who are too exhausted to turn off your sets. I'd like to say that our sponsors are bringing you this next half hour as a public service to sell soap. It's not that they think you're dirty, no, or anything like that, you understand. It's just that they like to sell soap. That seems to make them happy. You know, some people just... They like to sell soap. They're, darn these filter tips. I'm always lighting the wrong end. Are you always lighting the wrong end? I'm always, but of course that's the story of my life. I'm always on the wrong end of things. Like in crowded restaurants when a waiter spills a bowl of soup. Like take fires, you know, public fires. Like when the policeman says, "Everybody step back," I'm the guy they all step back on. And take dead-end streets. I am possibly the only motorist in the country who ever went down a dead-end street, turned around, and then discovered that the other end was dead too. There we were, my wife and I, trapped in a cul-de-sac. Fortunately, this particular time, Alice was wearing three petticoats, and we could spell out help. So there you are. And here I am, and here's the show.
Dial Shampoo, the new squeeze bottle shampoo that gives you that diamond sparkle look. And mild, fragrant Dial soap. that stops perspiration odor before it starts presents The George Gobel Show, starring George Gobel, with Hollywood's Jeff Hunter, Ravenna, Ohio's Peggy King, Aldo Ray's Jeff Donnell, our very own John Scott Trotter and his orchestra. Back and relax, friends, for here is the star of our show, the young man who now finds himself on the wrong end of a television set, George Gobel.
This is Academy Award time here in Hollywood, the exciting, glamorous home of the Nut Burger, also the Golf Burger, and also the Wish Burger. And a friend of mine named Sam Berger. See, the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences is about to give awards for the best performances, but they won't give any awards to the fellow who really does the truly hard work in the movie business. So tonight we honor the unsung heroes of the mighty cinema industry. Our first annual awards to the best moviegoers of the year 1954. The envelope, please. Thank you. He's been working pretty hard. The shine has all gone out of his leather bow tie.
Davy Crockett, king of the wild.